Howdy doody, buckaroonies. Harry Anthony Fantano here, back at you with another episode of Has Anyone Ever Told You You Have a Weirdly Deep Voice? Today, we're going to be putting on our working boots, getting us our big kid pants, grab us our toes and toe boxes, and talk about get you on them pooter rectangles, get you on Facebook. But more specifically, we're going to be talking about selecting or building you one of them pooter rectangles for the purpose of music production. I actually just upgraded my own home studio computer, so I figured it would be a good time to sit down and make this video because I get asked about this pretty often. This video is not going to be some start to finish guide hyping you up to build or buy some ridiculous Mountain Dew RGB hellbox, but rather a brief discussion on the components of a computer and how they relate to the process of music production, hopefully to give you a bit more of an idea of what you might need and help you make a better and more informed decision when it comes to buying or building your own home studio computer. It probably goes without saying, but in this video we're going to be focusing on the PC and Windows or Linux-based side of things, and we're not going to be talking Mac versus PC because I'm not going to poke that hornet's nest. However, if you are looking for a Mac system for your studio, I would say any of the modern M1 systems with 8 or better yet 16 gigs of RAM is going to be an exceptionally good choice. It's really pretty hard to go wrong with those, and that's all I'm gonna say about that. First off, the foundational component of your build is going to be the motherboard, and really most modern motherboards are a pretty safe bet. The biggest consideration with a motherboard is it going to fit the stuff you want to use in your build? When it comes to selecting a motherboard, the biggest thing is just making sure it fits the processor you want to put in it, it has enough USB connections, it has enough SATA connections for drives, it maybe has an M.2 drive if you want that, and it's got enough PCIe and other expansion slots to slap in whatever else you need in your build. Now, the big question, what about the CPU, and do we go Intel or AMD? And really, this is where I think a lot of discussions on music production computers sort of fall apart, because I think there's just a lot of misinformation and misunderstanding about how most modern audio applications work and utilize a processor. The TLDR of selecting a processor here, I think, is a modern i5 or AMD equivalent is a pretty safe choice, or better yet, if you can afford it, a modern i7 or AMD equivalent is going to be a really, really good choice. My old computer system has an i7-6700K in it, and honestly, if I was only doing music production and not doing any video stuff or other stuff I do, I could still use that computer just fine for music production and probably keep using it for several more years to come. Your CPU is your computer's brain, and it's basically a fancy rock that does a bunch of math, and when it comes to the world of audio applications, the single-core performance is still the most important metric, because audio and computers just doesn't take advantage of multi-core stuff all that often. Although some modern plug-in instruments can take advantage of multi-core systems, effects plugins just can't, and more often than not, audio ultimately becomes a serial process needing to utilize a single core to accomplish the thing. This is a grossly oversimplified explanation of how audio works and utilizes a CPU, but it's just way beyond the scope of what we're going to talk about here to get into this much further. I will say that most modern DAWs do have tools built in to separate the processes onto individual cores, but ultimately these individual cores are handling serial processes of different things happening in the DAW. And in the end, when it comes time to do the final export, the single core performance is going to be what makes or breaks the system. When it comes to selecting a processor and picking the right number of cores, I would definitely recommend looking at your DAW and what it recommends. Generally speaking though, a 4-core, 8-thread processor is going to be a pretty safe choice for most cases, but if you use really intensive plugins or lots of different plugins, expanding to an 8 or more core system or more thread system might be more beneficial, but it does come down to how many cores your DAW can effectively utilize. So, what about RAM? How much do you need, and what kind of RAM should I get? Generally speaking, you want to buy the fastest RAM you can afford with the lowest latency. How much RAM you need really depends on what you do in your production sessions, though. RAM is sort of a tricky thing, and the relationship between frequency and latency is actually kind of surprising. Although one stick of RAM might be very fast and very new, if there's a slower stick of RAM that has better latency, there might actually only be like a 1% difference in actual practical performance. RAM is a pretty important part of a computer, and it can be surprising how slapping some new RAM in your computer can breathe a lot of new life into it. When it comes to the world of music production, RAM is especially important if you use a lot of heavy sampled instruments because most sample stuff lives on the RAM for that session. So if you are a producer who uses a lot of Kontakt or Spitfire or whatever in your sessions, adding more than 16 gigabytes of RAM might be necessary. Similar to a CPU, the best advice I can give is to look at some of the plugins you use the most and check out how much RAM they generally require, and better yet, how much RAM they recommend you have. That can be a really good idea to establish a baseline of what you're going to need at the bare minimum to run a session and not want to smash your computer. Now, let's talk about storage. This is probably one of the most overlooked aspects of music production builds, and I think where people tend to cheap out a bit. Personally, I would always recommend going with at least a dual drive system of one SSD and one large hard drive, and always, always, always have some way to back up your stuff. I know way too many producers and sound designers and other folks who have lost everything because their main drive failed and that's where everything lived. It's not a good idea to put all your eggs in one basket. For something a little bit more robust, I would recommend checking into an NAS or network attached storage solution as well. Although external hard drives are great, NASs are really fast, they can be really ridiculously huge, and better yet, give you a backup of a backup of a backup of something if you've got RAID configured, and having that extra sense of a safety net is always a good thing, I think. Now, what about selecting a GPU for your music production computer? Because you don't really need a GPU for music production, right? Well, no. Having a GPU is actually a pretty good idea because most modern applications and plugins can use your GPU to draw the interface and do other things, and taking the added stress of this off your CPU is always a good thing. If you only plan on making music on your system, getting something as simple as a GTX 1660 can be a really solid choice. At least at the time of making this video, I feel that's probably one of the best values for the money, and it can even handle some light video related or gaming tasks if you want to get into that. However, I would argue that the modern producer is responsible for a lot of different things. Things like making their own music, making their own music videos, editing visualizers, putting together graphics and artwork, and maybe even doing some light 3D modeling and things like that. So for that, adding on a GPU is a good idea. However, what kind of GPU and how ridiculous it needs to be really comes down to you and what you plan to do on your system. Finally, closing things off in this video, what kind of case should you get? And maybe let's talk a little bit about cooling. When it comes to a music production computer, I always recommend fractal cases. These cases actually have acoustic panels built in and make your computer dead silent. When it comes to fans and cooling systems, the fractal fans or Noctua fans are awesome, especially if you can find liquid bearing ones. They're gonna be absolutely dead silent. And for a processor, I typically recommend an all-in-one liquid cooled system. These aren't really that hard to install and do a pretty good job of keeping things nice and frosty while maintaining a really, really low noise level. The last thing to consider with cases and everything else is definitely the power supply. I've actually known a few people who've blown up very expensive computers because they cheaped out here. You really don't want to cheap out on your power supply. It's a bad idea. When you buy a power supply, you want to make sure it has enough wattage for your system. You can check this with something like PC Parts Picker, and you want to aim for something with an 80 plus bronze or better rating. Do not cheap out on your power supply. It's a bad idea. And that's really it for this one. Hopefully this video was informative and gave you some tips for what to look for when buying or building your next production system. And of course, if you've got some other tips that weren't mentioned in this video, feel free to share those down in the comments. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned something. And as always, I hope this inspires you to get out there and make something awesome.